Hi, we're here today with Swiss race car driver Simona De Silvestro, also known as the Iron Maiden. Hi, Simona.
Hi.
Welcome to the Consulate. Could you tell us a bit more about where in Switzerland you're from and how you got into race car driving?
So I started racing when I was 6 years old, and I come from Mont-sur-Roll in Switzerland. My dad has a dealership in Nyon, and I've kind of been involved in cars since a really young age. You know, he used to say, my dad used to say that I was only quiet as a baby when racing was on TV. So I think I had the racing bug really early. And, you know, I did about 10 years of go-karting in Europe, and then 1 year in Formula Renault in the Italian Championship. And in 2006, I came to the US to do Formula BMW. And in the beginning, it was kind of just for 1 year, but I had a really great success with winning a race, and then went into the Atlantic Series and won 5 races there. And then the IndyCar series. So, so far my career has been pretty exciting over here in the US.
Okay, and what made you decide to go back to Switzerland for Formula One?
Well, going back to Switzerland, it's a big change for me, but you know, my big dream since I'm a little kid has always been Formula One. And I think as a race car driver, you know, this is the highest level and the pinnacle of motorsports. And I got this opportunity with Sauber Formula One team, which is also a Swiss team, which is pretty exciting. And you know, when you're a race car driver and a chance like this happens, you have to take it. And that's what I did, and now I'm working really hard to try to achieve my dream.
And how did you get your nickname, the Iron Maiden?
Iron Maiden came up in 2011, actually. This nickname is pretty special. You know, I used to have a Swiss Miss, which I think every person from Switzerland that comes to the US gets a nickname somehow. So I had a really big crash in practice at the Indy 500, and burned my hands really badly. And you know, it was the first time I got out of a race car and said that I wouldn't want to drive anymore. And a day went by, and then, you know, I kind of told myself I have to get back in. And on Saturday I qualified the car on pole day, which was a pretty big achievement for me. And the fans, I think, kind of liked that, and you know, they gave me the Iron Maiden nickname, which I think is a pretty cool nickname to have.
Definitely. So could you talk a bit about your campaign to raise awareness for clean energy and to promote STEM education?
Yeah, so I've been involved with the Clean Air Energy campaign since 2008. We started it in the Atlantic Series and brought it up into the IndyCar Series. And just to kind of, especially being from Switzerland, you know, we're really aware about nuclear and renewable energy, because, you know, we're really advanced in that part. And here in the US, a lot of people don't know about it. So with the campaign, what we've done, especially also with some of the sponsors like Arriva, we've gone to universities and gone to, like, younger kids to kind of get them involved in engineering and those different departments. And especially with the race car, you know, when you bring a Formula One car to a school, they get really excited because they think, oh, this is really cool. And the engineering that goes into those cars really plays well with the renewable energies. And also, I think the biggest thing on the me being a girl, you know, in a male-dominated sport, it's I've always had this dream of becoming a Formula One driver, and for sure racing, I think, is the most male kind of sport you can find, but that's what I've wanted to do. And I think it's really cool to kind of be a good role model for young girls out there to kind of, if they have a dream and they can do whatever they want, and just if they really work hard at it, you know, they can achieve that.
Yes, thank you so much for this interview.
Thank you.
Thank you.